You get on a train to come up to New York, was it? Where'd you ship out of?
I forget now.
I think it was New York, but I could have it wrong.
Probably.
And
probably.
And you, but now you find yourself going. Did you know where you're going when you got on that ship? Did they say your destination?
Not really. I think they might have mentioned Africa, but I wasn't sure.
You weren't sure. But a week later, you found yourself in Africa, and you by Casablanca, by Morocco. And you found yourself in a tent in Morocco, and just staying there.
That's right.
And and you said that at night you were as frightened as the beings.
The people over there.
Yeah.
That steal the eyes off you.
Yeah.
Try to.
Yeah, it was. But you were there. You were training there as well.
Yes.
You trained there. Yeah. And so you spent. Do you remember how long you spent in Africa, Morocco?
It wasn't long because right after Christmas, I was there at Christmas time, mm-hmm. And then we went to, in February. I went over
to Italy. But okay, I'm gonna stop you there. But you know, I asked Bob about his troop ship.
Yeah.
Coming over, you were the same kind of troop ship. What was your experience like on your troop ship?
What my experience was that I was down the lowest part of the ship, right at the bottom, and I got so sick that I thought I was going to die.
Mm-hmm.
So they come up, somebody came down and dragged me up to the middle deck, and once I got up there, I said, they'll never get me down there again. Mm-hmm. And I kept hiding around the deck there and was buying apples there with a nickel piece, and I was buying apples, and that's what I ate all the time till I landed, yeah.
Was it rough, the seas rough at the time?
Not really.
Yeah.
And I used to watch the officers and the woman up there have their parties there. They used to have dances and things up there, and I'd be watching them all the time, and till we landed over to, mm-hmm. to Italy.
So your troop ship experience is no happier than your troop experience. So anyway, we get you over to England,
yeah.
And from England, this is in still 1943.
Yeah.
You are going to almost six, 7 months of training.
Amphibious training.
Amphibious training, which was in Wales.
Yeah.
Well, how'd you find the Welsh, and how'd you find living in Wales all that time? I know you were training, but
I liked it. It was good.
Yeah.
I had a girlfriend too.
Oh yeah. Do you still remember her name?
Huh?
Do you still remember her name?
Florence Tucker.
Florence Tucker.
Yeah.
Okay.
In fact, she saw. She saw the ad in the paper about me when I went over to, you know, my brother and his two kids.
Yeah.
She sent me a letter.
Nice. All right.
Didn't my wife didn't appreciate it?
So anyway, you're training in Wales for an amphibious assault.
Yeah.
Okay. Now. June is coming around,
right?
And they marshaled you into an enclosed area. What was that like?
Well, we couldn't either go. We had American guards on the inside and Limey guards on the outside.
Limey's being English.
Well, yeah, English.
Okay.
And they were orders to kill us if we shoot us if we went beyond the. So I didn't care anyway. I stayed there.
Yeah, so you,
because they said we were going to be going in a couple of days.
But you knew that this was it. That this was the invasion was. Or well, did you?
Well, we had so many dry runs, we didn't know when the real one was coming up. But this one here looked like it because there were so damn many ships.
Mm-hmm. By a dry run, Bob, you mean you got off the boats, off the ships, over the nets, into landing craft infantry.
We would do. And you mean you want to know what a dry run is?
Yeah.
Dry runners, we had about five of them. They put us on a ship, but they're making us think that we're really going on the invasion.
Mm-hmm.
So we had loaded guns and everything else.
Ah.
We'd go out, but then they would turn around, but we wouldn't know they were turning around because it was dark. Mm-hmm. We did it at night, but by the time we land, it would be daytime. That's what they call a dry run. In other words, you're getting prepared for it. About three times they did it to us. Until we knew it was the real thing they told us.
So on June 4th, you actually load to go. You know,
we were loaded on. The original invasion was the 5th. Mm-hmm. But because of the weather, then they pushed it up to 6th. But they didn't tell us anything. We just went back to our cots. Mm-hmm.
But now June 5th comes and now you set sail.
Yeah.
And you know this is going to be the real thing because you're going out night and you're crossing the channel.
Right.
You knew you were crossing the channel.
Yeah, well, our boat was 12, 15 miles out.
Mm-hmm. Where could you hear the aircraft going over?
Oh, Christ, yeah. Uh-huh. That's all we saw, the Air Force going over there.
Could you see all the other ships at the channel?
Yeah, then we couldn't. It looked like do you remember the longest day?
I do.
When the guy looked out the window?
Yeah.
And he saw all the ships?
Yeah.
That's what it looked like.
It was just an Armada.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So you're approaching, and your beach was your beach that you designated to land on?
Omaha Easy Red.
Omaha Easy Red.
That was they took the beaches, gave them all names, but then they had different colors, like Easy Red, blue, the name of the blue was, I don't know.
But Easy Red was your designated area.
Yeah.
Now, once you got there, how did you, what happened then? What the sequence of events, what happened once you got to?
Once we got on the beach?
Yeah. No, not to the beach. You're on the boat, now you're going to go over the side.
Yeah. Going over the side? Yeah, we got to go over the side. We didn't have the ramp ones.
Okay.
What do they call them?
The scrambling nets?
Yeah, we had to come down the nets.
Onto the?
Onto the landing craft.
Okay. But so now you're coming ashore on this landing craft. The water was choppy?
Yeah, very choppy. In fact, a lot of us got sick. Mm-hmm.
You all saw the movie.
Both ends.
You all saw the movie Saving Private Ryan.
Yeah.
Do you remember as it opened up the scene, the choppy water on the landing craft? Was that accurate?
Right. But I didn't experience that they did in the movie because we had the landing craft, which was a LCI.
Right. Which means that it wasn't the ramp, but you went over the side.
Over the side, yeah.
And down a ramp.
Right.
Now you're coming in at high tide, though.
It was high tide, it was about in between.
Okay.
The tide was already coming in.
Okay.
It was low tide when the
How deep were you in the water when you actually hit the water?
Well, we were up to our knees.
Okay.
Right up to the knees.
So it was. You weren't up here, so you...
Yeah.
Okay. Now, as you're coming ashore, they were still firing.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, because our ship got hit right in the front, mm-hmm. knocked it back, so we couldn't get the ship out. Mm-hmm. But it was there a year later, too. Mm-hmm.
Now, when you're coming ashore, you said that you came across a major.
Yeah.
What was that? What happened?
Well, that was my first combat. I didn't know what the hell to expect. So I went up and I went to the beach and somebody was shooting at me. I figured it was a German. Mm-hmm. Right? So I fall behind this officer. I knew he was an officer because he had the stripe in the back of the head.
It was a white stripe.
It was
in the
a
back
white
of his
stripe,
helmet,
right?
Yeah.
Oh, I looked at him and he was yelling or he's shouting or whatever the hell he was doing anyway. So I said, I saw all the blood coming from his helmet. So I took my morphine out of my belt, gave him a shot of morphine up in the air. Next thing you know, the guy is practically dead. I turned him over and he had no face. I wasted morphine,
So you left and you went where did you go from there, didn't you?
Well, I had to get all my men together.
You were a sergeant.
I was a sergeant, yeah. I had to get all my men together and get down to the point where we were supposed to be. We were 500 yards off.
Where you actually landed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where the actual landing was. Where our actual landing was supposed to be. Mm-hmm. Because then according to the airplane survey, or the pictures, there was a road there. When we got there was no road, it was a footpath. So we had to start from scratch. We had to wait till we got a bulldozer in. And in the meantime, we had lost all our cover. The infantry was massacred coming in.
You could see the bodies and
Yeah. Oh yeah. That was worse. We had to stand there and clean up afterwards. I'll never forget that, I'll tell you. Mm-hmm. That was the worst part.
Mm. Let me go back to you, Charles. You find yourself, you're in Africa, and you're on a ship now going to Italy.
Yes.
And the funny part is your parents were born, or were from where?
Yes. Avellino Scogliani is the
well, and where you landed was not too far from there.
No, it wasn't too far because yeah. I found out that some people from down there were coming looking for me and never found me. If I had known I was that close, I'd have been going down there. But this was after I got out of my frozen feet. You know.
But anyway, so you landed close to where your yes, family's birthplace was, which is kind of ironic. But anyway, so then they load you on 2.5-ton trucks.
That's right.
They put you up, and off you go to
the lines.
To Anzio. Anzio.
That's right.
Anzio. Now you get into Anzio, right into the firefight there.
Right.
Tell me, there was a very famous gun. It was a railroad gun. It was called Anzio Annie. You ever hear another story about that huge gun that went up? They fired every so often. And hit the beaches.
Yeah, they got to, when they landed there, they got driven back, and instead of them going ahead, which they should have, they got pushed back, you know, and somebody said they made a mistake, that they should have been going forward, and so, you know, I don't know what happened, because I get after that, you know.
But when you got there, it was cold.
Oh, yes, so it was.
So you're in a truck, they get you 4 or 5 miles and they dumped you out. And they said, okay, you're in the zone now.
That's right.
So the first thing you do is what? Dig a foxhole.
Yeah.
You dug a hole.
It was late at night anyway.
Late at night. And some you said that somebody.
Yeah, I seen this other soldier up there and he was crying like. I said, what's the matter? He said, I don't know. He says, I just can't seem to dig a foxhole. Can I get in with you? I said, jump in, I says. Mm-hmm. So we stood the night together, but then it started after the next day it was raining and snow and sleet. There was no more foxholes. Mm-hmm. That's all we're in and valleys, like, you know. And
what was the area like? You said it was horrific. It was.
I think it was like a farm, like, because there was cows. You could hear cows mooing there. Mm-hmm.
Could you hear the guns going off?
Sure. Yeah. The guns. They never stopped. Them Germans never stopped firing. It was unbelievable with all that water, you know?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. They never stopped firing. And it's all, you look around and then you see bodies all over the place, arms and legs, you know. It was something, you know. It was always on my mind, you know.